Hey guys, I'm Styler, and this is my unboxing and full review of the Leica Eco LED TV Le 1 Pro, also known as the X800. The phone has in fact been on the market for some time with a price tag of $300, but recently the prices have dropped to about $200, and that makes this phone to one of the best in the price class. The brand was before called LED TV, but they recently changed their name to Leica, where the Eco stands for ecosystem, as they now sell a lot of different products and not only smartphones or TV streams. So currently this may be one of the best phones you can get for a low price, because the build quality and hardware is very high-end and better than on other phones in the same price category. In this video I will also show you how to upgrade the US firmware that the phone comes with out of the box. The reason for that is that the stock ROM is not recommended, as the browser and YouTube app is a bit buggy after you have made the simple firmware update. I will show that later in the video. These things will run 100% stable and fine, and this phone can be 100% recommended. So here you see some of the accessories included. Especially nice is that it also includes a small micro USB to USB Type-C adapter, so you can also use your old cables. The charger you have to connect to a US plug. I guess they made this so it also easy can be changed to another kind of plugs. The charger is rated 5V 2.0A, so this should be a quick charger. The shop also sent a power plug adapter, because I live in Germany and here we use another type than in the US. And last we have the USB Type-C cable in white. And notice that both ends are here reversible. Even the normal size USB connector can be reversed. So that is very convenient and that way easy to use. So that's it for the unboxing. In the top we find a front camera with 4 ultra pixels, light and proximity sensor and a multicolored notification LED. The display is on 5.5 inch from Sharp and with 2K Quad HD resolution. The whole backside is made of metal, which feels very premium. So let me remove the plastic from the backside and also here from the front, so we can have a better look. The phone is currently inside a clear case. Let me just try to take it out of that. On the back we find a 30 megapixel Sony IMX camera with OIS, dual tone flash, and in the bottom we see it says 64GB and that it is CE certified. In the bottom there are one speaker and one microphone. On the side there's the dual SIM tray and the power button. In the top we find the 3.5mm headphone jack together with an IR blaster. On the left we find the volume rocker together with a small mute button. The phone is comfortable to hold in the hand thanks to the slightly curved backside. So let's turn on the phone for the first time. It comes out of the box with an US firmware with multi-language, and there are tons of supported languages, but they may not all be translated 100%. I'm going to skip the setup and go straight to the start page. And let me first demonstrate the highest and lowest brightness. So the problem with this out of the box firmware is that YouTube comes pre-installed and that this version cannot be updated, so you're stuck with an old YouTube app. Let's fast also check the firmware version in the About phone, and as you notice there is no possibility to update wirelessly. The second problem is that the Mi browser doesn't work. Actually it will crash. as you see here. So the out-of-the-box firmware is kind of crappy. But there is an easy solution. You just download the two firmware updates from EFOX that I have provided in the video description. Install the Qualcomm drivers and follow this guide. I'm going to go through the update process with the first firmware update from EFOX. After you have unzipped the files, you inside the folder find a bat file. Here I have the phone turned off, so I'm going to connect it now to the computer. After that I start the bat file. And then a command prompt will pop up saying waiting for any device. Now I'm going to activate fast boot mode on the phone. To do that, just hold volume down plus the power button at the same time down for some seconds. Keep holding it down until you see a small penguin and then release the buttons. After that the flashing should start and you see in the command prompt that it will start to work. So now just let it be. This may take some time, 5 to 10 minutes depending on your computer. And when it is done it will show press any key to continue. So press the key 2 times and it will close. And then the phone will restart by itself. So the first time it boots it may take some extra time, that is normal. And then you get the setup screen again. Just go through it and then you're done. Notice that the Mi browser now is replaced by the Chrome browser, but the YouTube app is still there. So do the whole process again also for firmware update 2. That is the second update from EFOX. After that is also done, you end up with a cleaner ROM. Notice that the icons are a bit smaller and that it still have the Chrome browser, but the YouTube app is gone. So now you can install the latest version from the Play Store and enjoy better quality and more features. In the rest of the ROM you may not notice the big difference, but the stability overall have been improved and actually have not noticed any kind of problems while using this version. So now let's have a look at the phone in action. You can slide up here to go directly to the camera app, but let's just unlock. So the UI is very smooth. You can access the settings by pressing the menu button. Here you then have directly access to different phone features and shortcuts. Inside settings, when we look in display, you also have a lot of possibilities to tweak the phone. And further down we also find LED notification light. But one thing I noticed that doesn't work in the EFOX ROM is color mode. It seems to have no effect what you here choose. It just stays the same. Let's go back and let me very fast show you some more settings and options. And here also a look into the storage. And also here the RAM consumption. So about the half is used for the system and apps. Left is still 2 GB out of total 4. Inside accessibility there are also some few options. For example, pocket dial protection and other stuff. And last, let's see inside about. EUI is still just based on Android 5.0.2, so still no Android 6. Now let's check the remote control app. With that you can control different IR compatible devices. Like for example your TV, and it does support a lot of different brands. We can also try the mute button. That is in my opinion a very convenient thing to have, as you very fast can mute the phone in any situation. Next let's test the camera and let me try a test shot. And as you can see the shutter speed is very fast. It reacts almost instantly. Let me zoom into the picture and yeah, it looks incredibly sharp with a lot of good details. The camera app also offers a lot of settings, so you have great possibilities to adjust and tweak it like you want. In video mode it also supports 4K recording. And important is also that this camera has OIS, optical image stabilization, so videos will not get shaky. When you swipe up in photo mode, we also find HDR, night, square, etc. And last, there is also a panorama picture mode. The capacitive touch buttons have white backlight, but this is actually only visible in the dark or in dimmed places. The display has a visible dark bezel, not too thick, but still it is no near bezel-less to look at. And now let's check the viewing angles. Very nice. It is still possible to see the picture, even in low angles. And the 2K display is overall very nice to look at. The rear LEDs are bright, but not the brightest I have seen on a phone. Still, they do the job okay. In the rest of the video, I will show you some results from different test apps, and in the end, I will run a game, so stay tuned if you want to know more. So guys, that's it for the review. Remember also to check out my blog. You find the link in the video description. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment below. Give a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.